Statistics in Schools uses real data from the U.S. Census Bureau to show the relevance of statistics in everyday life. Offered at no charge to teachers of kindergarten through high school, the resources on the Statistics in Schools website are designed to supplement and complement teachers' existing lessons.
I think we're in a really interesting time in the development of statistics education. Never before has there been so much data available for so many people. Now you can get data from the Census website on so many different topics.
The Statistics in Schools website emphasizes cross-curricular learning and encourages teachers of subjects other than math to include statistics in their lessons.
Well, it's important when you're getting information to make sure you get an accurate sample that reflects the population. We're trying to get information about pretty much everyone in the country, so I can trust the source at the U.S. Census Bureau to already be on top of that.
One lesson I'd like people to learn is that statistics can enhance any discipline. And what is very exciting about projects like Statistics in Schools is it's helping teachers from other disciplines reinforce statistical thinking and critical thinking with data.
Statistics in Schools introduces students to the concept of data literacy, how they can turn numbers into useful information.
So this population they're talking about is the number of people that live in Virginia. They go and they ask all these questions, and so that's how we get all this information. They mail it out, people fill out forms, that's how we know, thanks to the Census Bureau.
What I liked about what I saw here was that the teacher was showing them a representation of where the data come from. And I think it's great that students begin to see the data as something collected by real people under real life circumstances and something that's happening every day around them. And that kind of drives home the relevance of it to their everyday lives.
Statistics in Schools features maps that allow students to visualize changes in data over time.
And it's just such a natural fit between the data that the census is collecting and trying to understand what it looks like across space. Why not add a map, you know, and why not really understand what maps can tell you?
Take a look at the map, right? Mark down things that you might be noticing. Mark down some interesting trends you might be seeing.
The maps have really important information, not just about the data that it's showing, but it gives you a lot of insight into what policymakers were thinking about at the time.
The interpretation of statistics lends itself to discussion and communication skills that all teachers want to incorporate in their classrooms.
Do we have an exact number? We remember the exact number? How many? Do you remember?
5,000.
5,000. For a land to be considered a territory.
If you're teaching a history class, it's possible to teach it just as received wisdom, where I'm the teacher and I'm telling you what the facts are. But when we talk about analyzing data and looking for trends in the data, everyone can participate. There's all sorts of data-oriented projects that work in the classroom, but still require a nice wrapper. So the Statistics in Schools tool can enhance what teachers are already teaching by bringing in data and helping the students think about how that data helps them understand the subject they're studying.
To learn what Statistics in Schools offers and how you can use this program in your classroom, visit www.census.gov/schools.